Some of the best things I've really enjoyed making this series over the years is the highlights that we've had personally together. So one of those was the Lamborghini Araco that I did with Ed in the early years. And we bought Lamborghini Araco that was in Poland, bought it back to England, we restored the car, it was amazing.
Yes. Lads, that is awesome.
Such a relief. I can't tell you how good I feel at the moment. Wow. And it was Ed China's birthday, so to celebrate, we arranged to go on a Lamborghini anniversary run to Bologna through the Dolomite Hills in Italy in this 1970s Lamborghini. It was just incredible. So I'll always have that memory. It was such a lovely thing to do. You know, I really enjoyed that. And Ed had a time of his life.
I think we should keep this car.
No, we definitely need to sell the motor. But the good news is, you get to drive it all the way back home.
Well, thank you, sir. It's been a fantastic test drive. Cheers, mate.
And then in the later years, working with Ant, we took a car and put it in front of the world and a global audience at Barrett Jackson car auctions. And that was the Austin Healey 3000. And there's no better measure of your work and putting it out there for the world to see and to judge and to put a hand up in the air and pay for it. And we took a $35,000 Austin Healey and sold it for $75,000 with the amount of work that we did to it.
That's why we're the Wheeler Dealers, son. That's why we're the Wheeler Dealers.
I'm really proud of that. That was fantastic. My least favourite car to work on, probably been two. It would be the Bentley in the early years. It was a Bentley Turbo that I bought. I challenged Ed to change the colour of that car, to take a Bentley apart and paint it and put it back together. In the allotted time that we have to make the show, was an impossible task, and I nearly broke everyone with that one. So that was a tough show, and I remember a lot of shouting going on to get that car over the finishing line. But look at the result.
Oh yeah.
You know, anyone who buys this car, how proud are they going to be? How much are you going to enjoy it? I mean, how much are we enjoying this motor right now?
It's glorious, isn't it? It's absolutely glorious.
Also a Chevy Bel Air. It was a Chevy 210 dressed like a Bel Air. I bought it in America, shipped it to England. Me and Ed were delighted with the car. It caught fire when I bought it. Oh, that was close. I mean, really close. Popped the bonnet and there was flames licking out of here. Actual flames coming out. So it was like a car that didn't want to be restored. It just wanted to die. But we dragged it over the finishing line and it turned out to be phenomenal. I think the best cars that we've done, they're yet to happen on screen. We've got some amazing episodes coming up. But looking back, I think the Austin Healey 3000 and first car, which was the Escort Cosworth, where we did the third wing on the Escort Cosworth, a phenomenal story to be told. It was brilliant because some people out there hated it that it had the third wing, but some people never knew that story.
The real triumph has to be this third wing. How was that never there in the first place?
I think Frank was right.
It's just so glorious to look at.
You think it looks good? Wait till you drive it.
The car that I'd like to do, wow, there's too many. They are coming up, actually. I've got loads of cars coming up in future episodes. But I suppose if I could one day do a 1929, 1930 Bentley blower, if somebody out there's got like £500,000 they want to throw my way to put one on Wheeler Dealers, that would be a dream car.
Click here to subscribe.